These are the 10 sheds that we lived in, and we are still living here today.
This is where my parents used, my mum used to live. It's very hot here during summer and very cold in winter.
And when it was raining, this is where we used to make fire and cook our stuff, and the rain still used to come down through here.
Where the water trips through during raining season.
We are people, traditional owners of Waikato Camp. My name is Felicity Hayes, and my auntie Susan
Chalmers.
I'm Wayona. Felicity's daughter.
Hello, I'm Anne Maria Palmer, and this is my grandmother Eva Hayes. And we are the traditional owners of Bundle Alice Springs. And this is where we used to live as we was growing up with our parents and our uncles and aunties who passed on, and our grandparents.
That have passed on.
And these are our children, and they are the next generation for Alice Springs.
And Whitegate. We haven't got any water at the moment. The tank's just up there. And it's empty.
We've got our water, and it's turned off.
And there's another tap there.
Mm-hmm. And one over there, there's like three taps, which ours is. We have to share it.
The water was cut off in 2014. This is where my brother used to live,
which he passed on, and now he's. Eldest son is taken over, and which he stays here, and he's sick too. He's under doctor's renal.
And we haven't got power at the moment.
There's no electricity. There's no sewage here. We grew up in this camp. Me, my sisters and brothers, and my other cousins. We've all grown up, and we've got kids of our own, and it's still the same, nothing's changed, nothing's happened. This is my grandmother, Susan, she's the traditional owner, and my grandmother, Eva. She and all her other families lived here as well. We have passed on. We were connected to the land. The land owns us. We belong here. Our ancestors come from. This is where old people were. Where they grew up and where they raised their family and their grandchildren.
Because her grandmother, before she passed away, she was the one who fought for Alice Springs, and she was never recognized. And she wanted a house built at her, a affordable house where she could live in, where she could call it home. But her dream didn't come true. And now my mother's taken that role for her.
To make it better. We make it a good environment for the whole family.
Because I was here a few years back, and I came visiting to my sister, and every time she used to talk about Whitegate with me. And now it's sad.
To know that she's passed on.
She's passed away. We've got our native title. And we're proud of it, and we're proud of our land. And we still want to be living here. My kids, they want to be here too. Yeah, we want the government to recognize us as traditional owners for Alice Springs and Bandua. That's what we want, and for Whitegate. That's what we want.